Hey, how you doing? And welcome to Livewire's Buy, Hold, Sell. I'm Ali Selby, and today we have an absolute cracker of an episode for you. We're going to be taking a look at three stocks with some of the lowest price-to-earnings ratios out there, and we'll also be asking our fundies to name one darling that's likely to drop from here. And to do that, we're joined by Neil Margolis from Merlon Capital and Ben McGarry from Totus Capital. Okay, first up, we have the flying kangaroo. It's Qantas Airways. It's on a forward PE of around 7.3 times. Ben, I might start on you. Is it a buy, hold, or sell?
Qantas is a sell. They cancelled my flight back from the US last week.
How dare they?
but there's actually more to it than that. We think they're over-earning at the moment. Capacity is going to slowly come back into the market, which will reduce prices. And I think they've cut too deep on the cost out with contractors, etc. And you know, the flight cancellations, the bag delays, it's eating into the brand. They're also facing a big CapEx refresh cycle over the next few years, which the new CEO will have to deal with. So Qantas is a sell for us.
They've had to ground quite a few flights recently, but their share price has definitely lifted up. It's up 19% over the past year. Neil, over to you. Is it a buy, hold, or sell?
Well, we do own it, so it's a buy, but with airlines, you always have to be close to the exit. Excuse the pun.
Oh, that was
I kept
good.
That one special. But look, I mean, there's government-owned competitors. They've got high upfront costs and low marginal costs, so it is an industry that you've got to be wary of. I think the difference with Qantas is their market position has actually strengthened through COVID. Their market share has gone from 60 to 70% in domestic. We ascribe about 80% of the value to the domestic segment, which includes loyalty. The international segment's a small part of the value. And in domestic, you've got Virgin, owned by Bain, who just want to maximize their short-term profits by trying to float it. So you know that Virgin is not going to compete aggressively in the next couple of years. So Qantas might be able to benefit from the pent-up demand and high margins for some time. The low multiple does reflect the fact that it is over-earning, though.
Okay, next up we have New Hope Corporation. It's a coal company. It's on a forward PE of 2.8 times. Is that one a buy, hold, or sell?
Well, look, it's a sell. This was our best stock during 2022, but we have exited it, so I have to call it a sell. I think with these stocks, coal prices are three times what they have been historically. The market's pricing in 1 to 2 years of these prices remaining this high. If you think they're going to stay high for longer, it's a buy. If you think they're going to stay high for shorter, it's a sell. The risk return is not there. History has shown us the best time to buy these industries is when there's blood on the streets. It's never been more profitable.
Okay, yep. As you said there, its share price is up 146% over the past 12 months. Ben, is that one a buy, hold, or sell for you?
It's a buy for us. We're kind of in the stronger for longer camp on coal. I think what's different this coal cycle is just the lack of supply. The hurdles to get a new project up and running is just so much higher than it was back in the 2010, 2011 boom. So difficult to see where the new supply comes from. Resource security is a big issue these days. So New Hope is the highest quality thermal coal producer on the ASX, and it's the only one with an organic growth expansion option in New Auckland. So we think it's cheap, and we'll if you can hang on for 12, 18 months, you'll get richly rewarded holding that one.
Okay, last up for today, we have Magellan Financial Group. It's trading on a forward PE of around 9 times. Ben, is that one a buy, hold, or sell?
Yeah, it's a sell for us, even though about 40% of the market cap is supported by the value of the equity investments. Funds management businesses, and particularly active funds management businesses, are quite fragile, very vulnerable to outflows.
Don't you run an active funds management business?
Yeah, if anyone wants to offer me 5 or 10 times multiple for Totus, yeah, talk to Ali, she'll get us in contact. Yeah, look, it's very difficult to turn around these ships on the inflows, and the new fund managers that have taken over from Hamish have yet to sort of prove their mettle. So until those outflows turn to inflows, it's a sell.
Its share price is down a whopping 40% over the last 12 months. Neil, is that one a buy, hold, or sell?
Look, its actual market value has gone from 12 billion at the peak down to under 2 billion. So it has fallen a lot, but it's still a sell for us. We quite like fund managers that are in inflow. They should trade on high PEs. Like, we don't mind trading on 20 times. Because they have very high return on capital, they don't carry much debt. And in the case of Magellan, they've also got fully franked earnings. It was one of our best stocks in 2012, for example. But right now, they're in a world of pain with the outflows. Their fees are still high. We think the current share price is pricing in another 25% drop in funds under management. So there's definitely some bad news priced in. But we think all the institutional FUM outside of the infrastructure business could get lost, and the retail book could halve. And on that basis, you'd probably want to be buying at around $7. But we could be getting a bit greedy there.
Okay, speaking of darlings that have dropped, we asked our fund managers to bring along one crowded trade that they think could suffer from here. Neil, what have you brought along for us?
Okay, the darling we're going to nominate is a very popular stock called Goodman Group. Industrial was always seen as the poor cousin of real estate because the cost of the building is low relative to the cost of land compared to shopping malls and office buildings. It always traded at a much higher cap rate than office and retail property. People have somehow been convinced it's now called logistics, not industrial anymore, so it sounds much more interesting. They've got, obviously, their last reported cap rate is 4%, which is below what it costs major banks to borrow five-year money at. And there's a lot of debt, obviously, within the business, but also within their funds. So if people do realise that industrial properties has got downside, then that's one that's going to struggle.
Okay, over to you, Ben. What's your darling that could drop from here?
Well, NextDC, data centres is a space that has attracted a ton of capital in the listed and unlisted space in recent years. Everybody's bought the migration to the cloud thematic. We think that a lot of the things that were working in their favour have started to work in reverse. So if you look at that, Amazon's, Microsoft and Google Cloud, the growth is slowing. These are long duration, very high PE assets that are sensitive to rises in interest rates. And if you look at their return on capital since they listed, it's about zero, and the shares on issue have tripled since 2013. So NextDC looks expensive and facing some headwinds, so that's a sell for us.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed that episode of Buy, Hold, Sell as much as I did. If you did, why not give it a like? Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're adding so much great content every week.